Hello everyone, welcome to BYJU'S classes. Today we shall be talking about an unprecedented development in the history of India and the history of specifically its judiciary. Yesterday, the four senior most judges of the Supreme Court held a press conference at the residence of the second senior most judge, Justice Chalameshwar. Along with him, there were the three other judges. They were Justice Gogoi, Justice Kurian and Justice Lokur. These four judges who spoke yesterday against the CJI, Mr. Dipak Misra, and expressed their displeasure with regards to how the Supreme Court was functioning in this era and in these times. They were sorry for the fact that they had to come out in this manner, but then they said very clearly that if they do not do this today, then the democracy of this country would be at stake. And the way the things are happening and the way the things have happened in the recent past under the leadership of CJI in Supreme Court, this is not going well. As it was made clear by these people that they had already written a letter to CJI around 2 months ago regarding the cases in the Supreme Court being given to a few of the judges who are junior to them. That is, most of the cases who are important cases related to some important matters, they are being given to some selective judges. And all this has left people all over the country, including the judiciary, stunned. It has something which may be of huge consequence in the following days, because as of now, we have only one side of the story. We haven't had the second side of the story, because till yesterday, only the Attorney General had said that these people should have refrained from asking or doing this thing in out in the open. So now what they are saying, there are certain issues. So we will look in this lecture, what all are those standout issues which has forced these people to come out and speak in the open. So, looking at this issue, one of the most important issues that is arising out of all this is the master of roster. We'll look into this, what exactly it is, what it is, and how does it make CJI more powerful, or CJI is just one amongst all the equals. Nothing more or nothing less, as has been specified in the letter which was written by these judges and which was released to the press also yesterday. Along with this master of roster, we shall also look at that particular case which started this all debate around 2 months back. That is the scam in the medical college admission, which has started, you know, or has opened this Pandora box. And that's how, you know, made these people, if I use this word, which may not be the most appropriate, but some may say they have come out in the open, they have broken the ranks, they have become a rebel. But as these judges had yesterday very clearly said, they are no more rebels. As they had clearly said, they had rubbished the whole argument that they were going on the path of rebellion. They said they were doing the things, what they were doing it only for the fact that they owed something to the country. After this, we'll also look at some other content of their, you know, anguish, that is the murder case of Justice B M Loya, which many people or some section of media has been attributing as mysterious. Other than this, we shall look at the issue of impeachment, because yesterday during the press conference, they were asked regarding the impeachment of CJI, what they have answered and what is the process of impeachment, how does this has been done in the past. We shall look at that also. And finally, we shall look at a very specific judgment, that is R.P. Luthra versus Union of India, under which we shall be talking about a bit about the collegium, the memorandum of procedure, the NJAC, all these things we will look here. So starting with the first topic, that is the master of the roster. So in this, we shall look at the two sides of the story, that is what the CJI is saying, what these people are saying. Master of the roster, make it very clear, it is just a power which lies with the CJI, under which they decide, or the CJI decides, which case will go to which judge or which bench in the Supreme Court. You can see it has very clearly declared, that is the constitution bench which was formed, which we'll be talking about, declared that CJI, and in this particular case, Mr. Dipak Misra would only be the person who would be taking care of this judgment or this decision. At the same time, they made it very clear that only the CJI has the exclusive power to decide which case will go to which judge in the Supreme Court. No other judge will be deciding, or neither any other judge will be instructing the CJI to set up any bench or to set up or look into any particular case. This was ruled by this constitution bench. Very peculiarly, they are saying nobody would be instructing, because under the thrust of this decision, they said if everybody starts directing the CJI to assign them some particular case, it might lead to complete chaos in the situation. It might lead to complete administrative anarchy as far as the judicial system of this country is concerned. And that's why we will look into the judgment which came under which ruling. We'll just now look into from where was this constitution bench formed. If we look at the other side of the story, what these people are saying, at the very beginning I had said that these people have said that the CJI is just first amongst the equal, does not give him any more power, neither gives him any less power. So what they are saying is that under this whole thing, of course CJI is the master of the roster and it is his privilege to determine who will get which case. But then what they are saying is, this is an arrangement. This was an arrangement which was done so that the transaction of the business, the appropriate arrangements with regards to all the members. For example, today Supreme Court has some 25 members. Two were recently appointed. If we take that too, then 27 members are there in Supreme Court, though the strength is, we all know, about 31. But then this was only done so that, you know, there should not be any dispute, any conflict. It is just that it was done for disciplined and efficient transaction of the business of the court. But it does not give any real authority, either the legal or the factual, to Chief Justice over the members of the Supreme Court, other judges of the Supreme Court. They have very clearly specified CJI is only first among the equals, nothing more, nothing less. Apart from this, they are saying in the jurisprudence, there is that CJI is only first amongst the equals, nothing more, nothing less. Then they are also saying that there is time-established, you know, rules, well-settled, time-honored conventions that guide the CJI. And what are these conventions? What are these rules that they are talking about? They are saying that this should be that all the cases which are coming to the Supreme Court, they should be heard by appropriate benches. And when we talk about the appropriate benches, we talk about the composition of the benches. We talk about the strength of the benches. We are talking about a natural corollary of these two, that any case which has to come should have a multi-numbered judicial body, and that there is any departure from this well-established rule, because then it would be unpleasant, which we are seeing as of now, which will be undesirable consequences, and this will create doubts in the mind of ordinary public. So now, let us look into from where has this all started? Where does this master of roster, it was not a thing, it was so much settled. So suddenly, how come this news has come into this whole thing? So for this, just go back 2 months before, there was a news in the Supreme Court regarding a scam which was concerning the medical college admission scam. Under this, what was happening in those days was that two petitions were filed in Supreme Court, and these two petitions, they were seeking that there should be a separate SIT which should look into the FIR which was filed, which was registered by CBI, which in which they were looking into the matter that some former judges of different high courts had concluded or had done a conspiracy, that is, in this, the name of one particular former Orissa High Court judge has come very openly, that there was a conspiracy hatched by these people along with Hawala operators, that they would get some favorable judgment for a particular college of UP, and this favorable judgment would be seen by having or by bribing the Supreme Court judges. So now the case is involving corruption in the highest echelons of the power. So you can look, they were talking about some bribes being paid. Now here the mat was that one of the petitioner, in this case the Supreme Court lawyer, Lawyer Kamini Jaiswal, had asked that CJI Dipak Misra, he should not be listening to this matter because Mr. Dipak Misra had taken participation in few of the judgments before in which the medical colleges were involved. And as such, it would be a perfect case of conflict of interest. Now, what happens under this is that this matter was heard urgently by a two-bench led by the second senior most judge of the Supreme Court, Justice Chelameshwar. And in his order, five judge bench would be formed, in which the five judges would be the five senior most judges, and they would be urgently hearing this case. But very soon, in the very next day, what happened is that this judgment, which was pronounced by the second senior most judge, was nullified by a constitutional bench which was led by the CJI, Mr. Dipak Misra. In an unprecedented hearing, he nullifies this, saying that only the CJI is the master of roster, and as such, only he has the power, or in this case, just being by the fact that he is the CJI, to decide who would be hearing which matter. And as such, nobody else can decide which bench or which panel of judges would be looking into which matter. So now, this petition wanted that investigation should be transferred from CBI to SIT, which will be supervised by a retired CJI. But then this judgment, this case was heard by the bench led by the CJI. And in this, he very clearly nullified the previous order of the second senior most judge and said any larger bench which has been formed by the second senior most judge will be nullified, will be ineffective, and the CJI formed a four-member panel of judges, that is Judge Dipak Misra, Judge Amitav Roy, Judge A.M. Khanvilkar, and Judge R.K. Agarwal, and Judge Arun Misra. So 4+1, these five-member panel was appointed to look into this matter. And later on, they dismissed this case, the Supreme Court dismissed this petition that which was filed by the advocate for looking into a special SIT probe in the medical college bribery case, saying that this was nothing, but it was scurrilous and per se contemptuous with regards to the CJI. It was a case which was only done to grab some eyeballs and nothing more than that. And that's why they said they will not be looking into this. But then this had opened the Pandora box, because in this order, CJI very clearly said that he, being the head of the Supreme Court, is the only person to look into the master of roster. But then what would be the case if CJI is not present because of any reason? Let's say he is ill. So who would be the person who will be taking care of all these? So this was the first case which anguished and which pained these judges. Another very important thing that they have raised in their letter is the Judge B M Loya's death. As you can look, this man, who was the judge of Bombay High Court, died mysteriously, according to certain media reports. The thing is, Supreme Court has taken cognizance of this issue also. And yesterday only, Supreme Court, in a separate case, just a few minutes before the press conference which was to happen, they termed that this is a very serious issue. They have asked Maharashtra government to give all the matter, all the case, all the things related to the case to the court on Monday. So now, how does and why does this case get attached to this? The whole thing is, who is this man? The thing is, he is a former, now posthumous judge of Bombay High Court who was listening to a very high profile case, which was a fake encounter of Sohrabuddin. In this case, the name of BJP President Mr. Amit Shah was coming. And after the death of this gentleman, after almost 3 years of his death, the certain magazines and certain media personals have brought some of the things which point that there was some sort of, let's say, conspiracy or some foul play as far as his death was concerned, because there was an allegation which was leveled by one of the sisters of this former judge that this man was offered some 100 crore rupees in this case to give a favorable judgment. Now, what is true, what is not true, we are not going into this because we don't have all the facts ahead with us. But at the same time, how does these senior most judges, they come into this? The whole thing is, yesterday, as I said, this case has come into the Supreme Court and they have assigned the Monday to be the day. But then here also, as you can see, Supreme Court saying it's a mysterious death, it's a serious matter. They have asked everything from Maharashtra government to be submitted on the coming Monday. But at the same time here, these four senior most judges, they are saying that again, this case, which is so important, which is a bit controversial, again has been assigned to a particular court number 10 and not to any of the first four benches, which is led by other four senior most judges apart from the CGI led bench. Another issue which has been raised by these people. So now, in yesterday's press conference only, there was a question which was asked by one of the press people, that is, did they believe, it was asked from these four gentlemen, that did they believe that CGI should be impeached? And there the Justice J. Chalameshwar had very categorically said that we are nobody to decide, let the nation decide with regards to the impeachment. So here only comes the question, what exactly is this process of impeachment? For those who know, we know that it is under the 1968 Judges Inquiry Act that if any member of the higher judiciary, that is in this case Supreme Court or High Court, he or she has to be removed on charges of incompetence or gross misbehavior, there is a process called impeachment process. That is, you can see that higher judiciary only we are talking about. It can be the chief justices, judges, or the state high court's chief justices and judges, and they can be removed by this process which we are calling as impeachment under the article 124(4) only on two grounds. That is, either they have proven misbehavior or they have been incapable of handling this important position. So here we will be looking at the process of this impeachment. That is, the first step as far as the impeachment is concerned is that when this procedure is coming into the Lok Sabha or Rajya Sabha, that is, a complaint is filed into Lok Sabha or Rajya Sabha, it cannot be filed by any single member. In Lok Sabha, a minimum of 100 MPs. In Rajya Sabha, a minimum of 50 MPs are required. They will sign a duly signed motion. This motion will be brought to the notice of the respective presiding officers. That is, in the case of Lok Sabha, the speaker, in the case of Rajya Sabha, the chairman, and these will then form a three-member committee. That is, you can look. Now, the presiding officer, whether it's in Lok Sabha or Rajya Sabha, will form a three-member committee. The three members in this case will be, if the case is against a Supreme Court judge, in that case, there would be two judges from Supreme Court only. Or if the case is with regards to a High Court judge, then in that case, two members would be, one member a Supreme Court member, another a Chief Justice of a High Court. Third member in these two cases, in any of the situation, whether it is against the Supreme Court judge or whether it is against the High Court judge, it would be an eminent jurist who will probe this case and look whether this case is a fitting case for initiating a process of impeachment. Three-member committee being formed, two judges, one from Supreme Court, one Chief Justice of High Court, if it is against a High Court judge, two Supreme Court, if the complaint is against a sitting judge of the Supreme Court, and then the third member is a jurist who would look into this complaint and determine if it is a fit case for initiating the process of impeachment. This three-member panel can have any independent agency. It might be the government body, it might be a private sector body to investigate these charges, because they will not be investigating the charges on themselves, and then they will make a recommendation to the concerned houses. After they have done the recommendation, this committee will decide whether it's a perfect case of impeachment, yes or no. If it is no, then the matter is closed. If it is yes, then this matter has to be discussed in both the houses. When the matter is being discussed in both the houses, the concerned person against whom the charges have been leveled, he also or she will also be given enough time to rebut the charges. But then all these things should be done in a single session of the house. That is, in the same session, this has been passed. At the same time, how will it be passed? It has to be passed by a special majority. That is, two-thirds of the members present and voting, and this number, two-thirds, should not be less than a simple majority. You can see, if the House has decided to put this motion to vote, it has to be passed by two-thirds majority in both the Houses in the same session. So then, after this has been passed in both the Houses, this is sent to the President, who will sign this and will be, the judge will be impeached. So here only, just for knowledge sake, we have to remember, never ever in the history of our times, in the history of modern India, there has been any judge who has been impeached. There has never been this. Though the process has begun against many people, formerly, for example, names like V. Ramaswamy, the judge who had the dubious distinction to be the first judge to be started or to be put on the process of impeachment, but then it was not done against him. Soumitra Sen, the Calcutta High Court judge, he was the first judge who resigned even before this impeachment process could be carried out. P.D. Dinakaran, another Chief Justice of Sikkim High Court, he also resigned on the charges even before the impeachment proceedings could start against him. So these are some names which are there. Lastly, in this case, there is a particular case which has come, that is R.P. Luthra versus Union of India, which has been specifically mentioned in the letter signed by these four judges. To understand this judgment, we have to slightly go back into the historicity, which we are not going to deal as of now. We have to understand, in this, there will be the issues of collegium coming, there will be the issues of NJAC coming, there will be the issues of memorandum of procedure coming, and then we shall be looking all these. So what we shall do is, these we can do separately in another lecture. As of now, just to tell you what all has happened is that NJAC was, you know, struck off by the Supreme Court and collegium system was allowed to continue. But then one of the results of this was something of MOP, that is memorandum of procedure came, which tweaked the whole process, and the outcome of NJAC case was that this MOP was modified so that to make it much more accountable. And that's why after this, there was a long tussle between the government and between the judiciary on account of the appointment of the judiciary positions. For the example, the last Chief Justice, the previous to previous Chief Justice, CJI, Mr. T.S. Thakur, was one of those people who had criticized government a lot for not doing the judicial appointments. Later on, Justice J.S. Kher, the next Chief Justice of India, CJI J.S. Kher, he in March this last year, that is in 2017, finalized the MOP. But now what happened was, recently there was a lawyer whose name is Mr. R.P. Luthra. He filed a case in Supreme Court, in which he filed a case where he challenged the appointments made to the higher judiciary in the absence of any revised MOP. Now, under this, the this case had gone to the two-member judge, that is Judge Adarsh Kumar Goel and Mr. UU Lalit. They both rejected this Luthra's challenge, but then they saw that fine enough, they got something that there should be no further delay in finalization of MOP in the larger public interest. Now, here only we have to understand that there is, which we all must have heard, the case of Judge Kannan, in which the seven bench judge had convicted him for 6 months, and it was felt that MOP, because the government had not answered anything on MOP, that government has accepted this MOP as it was. And that's why many people, and this time also, some critics are saying that by having this case in which they are, you know, looking into MOP again, and later on what was done was, instead of a two-member panel here, CJI took it on himself and formed a three-member judge panel, which included Judge A.K. Sikri and Judge Amitabh Roy. And they both, on 8th November 2017, they gave a judgment which recalled the previous order which was given by the two-member judge. Now, under this, you have to understand that most of the people are saying that when the seven-member judges had imprisoned Judge Kannan, who was, you know, in the history of India, the first sitting judge to be imprisoned, then only they had almost finalized the MOP. And because the government had been sitting on this, they had not answered, so it was felt that this was done and dusted. But from this case of Mr. R.P. Luthra, where he had prayed that MOP be finalized, it is giving a backdoor entry to the government to re-come into this issue and look into the matter, which according to most of the people has been done and dusted. So here only, thing is that initially when there were only seven judges in Supreme Court and all those seven used to listen to any particular case, so how could be the case which has been done and dusted with a seven judge bench, how could two judge bench listen to that? And later on, how could that two judge bench case also be transferred to a three bench judge? Because again and again, I'm reiterating that MOP, which was sent by the Supreme Court to Government of India in the last year in the March, because government did not come back to it. So it was always felt that government has accepted it. Now by reopening it, what they have done is they have given a backdoor entry to the settled issue. They are again going to come to this resort through the Attorney General. So this is another matter which has perturbed these people, that how could, you know, they reopen a thing which was already decided by a much larger bench. Overall, if we conclude this whole thing, we have to understand at this moment, we have given only one side of the picture. That's the first thing, that's the conclusion. At this moment of time, if we look only from one side, it is true that the letter which was written has been something which has given a lot out. The differences in the judiciary is out in the open. Of course, it has not painted anybody gloriously in this whole play. But then we have to understand that the issues which have been raised by these four people, who are eminent people in their own light, is not something that can be brushed under the carpet. If there is a matter, if there is something which may disturb or which may destroy democracy in our country, then that matter should be urgently listened to. We cannot allow in any manner to let our judicial institutions suffer. We have to understand judiciary is one institution which has been way above all the doubts level. Its integrity cannot be, you know, put under the slightest of the doubt. And that's why the CJI, under whom a few of the controversial cases have come one after one, whether that would be the scam of the UP medical colleges or the death of Justice Loya or these things which has happened yesterday, has not given a great signal. So now, if the matter is that it should be that the cases should be allocated in a much better manner, those things should be done, because we shall wait for the second half of this whole thing, what the other side is also saying. But then this episode has not helped the cause of Indian judiciary. That's the final conclusion for as of now. Thank you.